And that, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, is how you play the game of golf. And that is why you will never see me playing golf on TV. But anyways, you know what? We had longtime members Carl and Gord on, and they said that they didn't want to be seen golfing, but they said the two hottest golfers at Pine Ridge are Charlie and Josh. So there you go. And that was a nicely played hole.
That's as good as I can do, Tracy. That's the best I can do.
Well, hey, you are going to be in the Players' Cup. So right. First of all, with Charlie here, do you have an advantage?
Since I definitely do, yeah. This course, it's very tough because the greens are so tough. So a lot of people that come struggle, and I get to play here every day, so I get to see the breaks, and I think it is an advantage, to be honest.
And Josh, well, you're trying to qualify for the Players' Cup.
Yeah, I've been here for quite a while, and like Charlie said, it's an advantage, and so hopefully I can get into the tournament and use that knowledge I have as an advantage.
How did you get into golf?
My family played in Glenbrough, and we did it as family outings and played on the weekends and stuff like that, so that's how it started for us.
All right, so there is a great group of young golfers here, so it's pretty competitive. How do you rank Manitoba golfers right now?
It's tough. We don't have very many tournaments around here. That's why you see a lot of amateurs try and get into the Players' Cup. So, I mean, you can look at the Manitoba Amateur and how we perform in the Canadian Amateur, but I mean, a lot of the good players that come out of Manitoba come out of Pine Ridge, so you can see why, because of the greens, of course, and it's such a good place to play. And actually, Josh was the one that got me out here in the first place, so yeah, it's a good place to be.
Awesome. Okay, so let's talk about game day tournament. I mean, it's 90%, I think, mental and 10% physical, but how do you prepare?
Usually just go through and think about the clubs I want to hit off the tee, the spots, and you think about angles you want in for your second and third shots and low places on the green where you can putt uphill, mm-hmm. stuff like that. So I'm more thinking my way, the strategy of how I'm going to play it, maybe not getting myself mentally prepared. That is kind of how I do it, not so thinking of how I'm going to conduct myself out there, but if I have a good game plan, then the mental game kind of follows.
Yeah, so, and for you, Charlie, when a hole just goes all wrong, what do you go through to say, okay, the next one?
It's very tough, but you just kind of have to let it go. And I mean, I've struggled with that in the past, so like most people, but yeah, you just got to be positive and think happy thoughts and just try your best. I mean, it's one shot at a time. Like, one shot early is the same, is just as important as one at the end. So you got to put as much importance on the next hole.
Okay,
so you
got to
be, yeah.
I wanted to ask you, Tiger wears red at the, you know, the final day.
Yeah.
Do you have a special color?
I don't have a special color.
Well, maybe that's good. You know, it's not working for Tiger.
It's not working right now.
All right, well, congratulations to both of you. I know that you will make it into the tournament.
Thank you.
And we look forward to covering it and following you guys along the course.
Thanks a lot.
All right, so Charlie, Josh, two names to look for at the Players' Cup. We are going to head into a break, and when we come back, it's all about the girls in golf.